I can tell you about a personal experience. The fact that you can see a lot of the children running in the streets, and when knowing that you are the only protection that they have, that was very touchy about it.
My roommate was a medic, so she worked, she went on some convoys to be the female medical person in case something happened. There was a woman in one of the villages that they went to that needed some help, and she risked everything to come talk to us to help get help for her child. She had heard that we helped, you know, we extended our medical care to them and to the local populace, and she risked everything to come get help because we were our only hope.
The most touching for me was losing my sergeant major. My sergeant major was killed. Any soldier being killed was bad days. All very tough days. So that's something you quite never get used to. When you lose somebody like that, of course, he was the senior ranking guy in the brigade, a very well-respected, well-known, well-liked, very competent, capable guy. So having that happen was not an easy time. And giving his eulogy was that's probably the toughest thing I did over there in 27 months.
I can't remember now if it's two or three little girls, they came up to me, they had all these flowers in their hand, and they gave them to me, you know, and then they were actually fleeing Baghdad. And they gave me some flowers, and I thought that was really nice because it wasn't their parents didn't tell them to do it or anything like that. They just did it on their own.
Probably the most touching thing is one of my best friends actually joined the military a week after me, and seeing her over there was real nice because it's nice to see somebody from home when everything's so stressful and she can just kind of take away the mood.
What was the most touching thing that happened to me in Iraq? I don't think I can share that one. I guess one I could share was driving along in my vehicle, and there's a young woman on the side of the road just crying. And of course you instantly think, okay, is this an ambush? But that's not a typical scenario for a young lady to be crying on the side of the road. So we stopped the car, we got out. There was a situation developing where this lady probably would have been very much dead within a few hours. And we changed that with our presence, and we escorted the young lady to a safe area. But as we parted, the look in her eyes, because she knows very clearly that we just saved her life, can't even describe that look. Just absolute thanks and gratitude. And there's no way I can ever repay you type look in her eyes. And then to see her smile and then wave goodbye. That's probably worth the whole trip over there.